With ProPresenter 7, if you want to create a pre-service loop, first you add your images, or in this case, we've got slides that have element transitions on each of those. These are just the default ones that Renewed Vision added. Then we need to have a go to next timer on each, and while you could add it individually, I just clicked and dragged so that I can add it on all of them. So let's click go to next timer here. These were all set at different times. I'm actually going to make them all 7 seconds, and then click done. And on the last one, if you don't already have it, you will have to add the action where it loops back to the first slide. So you can do that from the go to next timer here and make sure loop to beginning is checked. Click done, and then you're good to go. So each of these will stay up for 7 seconds. Then once this 7 seconds is done, it will loop back here. But what if you wanted to schedule either the pre-service loop, or maybe you want a countdown to be scheduled? Either way, in ProPresenter 6, it was called Scheduler. Well, they've changed the name and changed a little bit of the functionality here. So if we go into View and go down to Calendar, which makes sense, you want to put it on the calendar, then we get this dialog. Now, I've already enabled one new event for, I'm recording this January 17th, 2020 at 3:27 p.m. So at 3:30, this is going to start. Now, I could have it repeat every once in a while. I could have it end. But in this case, what's really important is that it starts today at 3:30 p.m. And what I want it to start is, I can choose any of my playlists that I have over here, but in this case, I want this one that I started yesterday, 2020-01-116, countdown, and that will automatically start this one. This has the, so let me click on it, right click, I have added the action, let me go to the action palette, of a message. That's what this icon means, a message. So it's a message, but it's a message that has a timer on it. Formerly those were called clocks, but that's what I did. And I have a go to next timer of 0 on it. So all this does is it starts up the countdown clock and then immediately goes to the loop. And that should start here in just a minute. So let's watch and see exactly when this starts. Right here is where you're going to want to look. And we see that it started. It's a little hard to see. I should have applied a different template, or actually theme now, to it. But you can see it on these darker backgrounds. So that's how you do that to keep this from restarting every time the loop restarts. You can have it just automatically start up here and then go into your pre-service loop, which loops until your service starts. So that's how to make a pre-service loop and a countdown timer and have those work automatically at a certain time with calendars in ProPresenter 7.